Welcome back to my channel. My name is Emily and I talk a lot about Salesforce. Today we're going to be talking about big objects within Salesforce and why you'd kind of want to use them. But first, let's go ahead and hop into setup so we can dive a little deep. Let's go ahead and type in big, go to big objects within data. So big objects are used for when you have a lot of data. These could be for different types of inputs or records or very, very large data. Examples of this could be historical event data, web log files, archival data. I'm going to hit new so we can create a new big object. So we can create the label for this. I'm going to say customer input. Then create the plural. This is very similar to how you'd create a regular custom object. We could create a description. I will open up the help and training window. And we do not have the option to deploy this quite yet, probably because we have some other stuff that we need to do first. Okay, so from here, we can go ahead and enter in some new custom fields. I'm going to create a text area long, have this be feedback, and hit next. Allow it to be visible to everybody, hit next, and save. All right, and that is how you create a big object within Salesforce. We've created a custom field. One thing that we do need to do is have a custom index, and because this is not deployed yet, we would need to go into the profile and have it be available. I'm going to go into the sysadmin profile, system administrator, and edit. Let's go to custom objects. Or big objects. Here we have create, read, edit, delete. So it looks like we are good to go as far as the big object for the system administrator profile, which may be the only profile that we use this for. Again, big objects are for any sets of large customer data. So maybe if you had a form go out to all past and previous customers or prospective customers as far as feedback goes, you would want to have a big object to take in all that data so then you can deal with it properly rather than having a survey object or another object depending on the amount of customer data that you're expecting to receive. But again, that's how you create a big object within Salesforce. It is a little bit different than creating a custom object with the object manager. So if you have any questions, be sure to drop them down below, and I will get back to you as soon as possible. Thank you so much for joining me. Like, subscribe, check out the courses down below, and if you'd like to join our email list, you can do so at salesforceemily.com. Thank you so much, and I will catch you guys in the next one.